doing today? My name is Shane. This is my 1990 Chevy C1500. Yes, it's purple. Only one that I see down here in southern Indiana like it. Alright, we're going to start off with the whole front end. This is a brand new front end off of a Tahoe. I didn't like the beehive with the grill, so I got this one off the Tahoe. Makes everything look a lot nicer up at the front. I painted the Chevy emblem black just because it matches the hood. Alright, now we're going to take a peek underneath here. Alright, this is a 1590 cubic inch V6. This thing is a monster. I've kept up with top fuel dragsters in the 1,000-foot drag strip. Yeah, he got me off the takeoff, but I got him on the big end, running about 330 miles an hour. But this is a sleeper, believe it or not, because this, people think that that's an air filter. It's not. What you're looking at right here is a supercharger that I built myself out of Shania Twain and P. Diddy. This thing is one heck of a breather, I'll tell you that right now. But now we're going to look over here at this all aluminum radiator. They don't make them like this anymore unless you go to the local pawn shop. Got this one for two tires and three lug nuts. Got it for one heck of a deal. Right over here is my Optima yellow top battery. My voltage never dropped below 14 there if I'm taking off doing a wheelie down drag strip. But alright, now I guess we can take a look at the exhaust. Follow me. Alright, this is a full 3-inch exhaust all the way from the headers back. So loud you can't hear yourself think, which is a great thing because whenever I think, I go buy new tires. But it's made out of a new steel that I just invented myself. Can't tell you what it is because it's a top secret. Just know that the U.S. military is using it. But, all right, we're gonna. I ain't gotta really talk about the exhaust very much because it talks for itself. But we're gonna talk about my tonneau cover now. We're gonna open it up for you. All right, I got these new upgraded hydraulic arms, so it won't drop at all unless you pull it down with all your might. We're going to talk about the Chevy emblem up here on top. It's lowered, so I figured I'd put something on the top because everybody come driving by with the lifted trucks think they're all that. It shows them who the real king is. That's the man with the Chevy. Alright, we're going to talk about this wing back here. This wing really helps me a lot, keeping me down on the ground whenever I take off the drag strip going about 330 miles an hour, passing up the top fuel dragsters. Everybody tells me this wing is on wrong. It is. Alright. If I didn't tell y'all, the engine makes about 8,000 horsepower to the rear tires. But speaking of tires, we're going to talk about them. Alright. These are BF Goodrich P235s on the front. It's a staggered setup, so I got wider ones on the back. Got a big sidewall on the side of them, so whenever I pop the wheelie and come down, it don't break my back. And yes, she is lowered. It is a 4-6 drop. I like to ride low and slow because, well, truthfully, I'm scared to go fast in it. Alright, I'm going to walk over here in the back tires. Alright, we got P275s back here. BF Goodrich. These things hook up magnificently when I'm going down the drag strip. You know, sometimes, this is my third exhaust being on it because whenever I have to pop that wheelie, the exhaust will drag the ground sometimes. But truthfully, this is my second favorite tire. And number one are some Sticky Mickeys. Man, I sure like to have it. Alright, but we're going to talk about the transmission now. This is a 5-speed manual. If it ain't a mail, you don't have no mission. But I got a story about it. I knew this old GTO that pulled up to me one day at a stop sign. He said, revving his engine, man, it sounded pretty. But he didn't have 1590 cubic inch engine under, so I knew I was gonna have him off the takeoff. But we sitting there revving it up. He honked. On the third honk, we both dropped the clutch out of it. Well, clutch wasn't the only thing that was being dropped. Transmission dropped right on underneath the thing. Guess what? That's what I get for using a stock trans on 8,000 horsepower. All right, but we're going to talk about these tennis balls back here. You know, believe it or not, there was two here, but there's two on the other side. There's only one back here now. But truthfully, I got some subs back here, but you can't hear them because the exhaust is so loud. But I try to do everything I can not to hear that exhaust, because it just turns on the need for speed in my body. But this is the 14th engine that's been in here. I put four of them in here. It was a four cylinder at first. Then I made it up to a six cylinder. Then I built my own six cylinder. Made my way up to this six cylinder. It redlines at about 1300 RPM. Putting out at the cranks probably about 1100 kilowatts of power. But the truck, there is a lot of weight reduction down to it, believe it or not. It is a short bed, standard cab, so that brings down the weight quite a bit. It only weighs about 5,000 pounds, which is, it's not very much for 11,000 kilowatts of power at the crankshaft. But yeah, I just wanted to give y'all a little sneak preview what the exhaust sounds like. So if I can, I'll get you to walk back there real quick for me. That just drained about 6 gallons of fuel out of her. Speaking of the fuel system, come on. All right, if you look down through here, you can see my stainless steel gas tank I just put in there. It's a 67 gallon tank. Only can run corn and whiskey through it. It's the only thing it'll run on. If I go to any gas station around here, won't even turn on. I have to go to my uncle's farm and get corn and whiskey and just throw it right in the gas tank, and it runs just like a beauty. And a lot of people think that my truck smells bad from all the whiskey and everything, and yes, she does run a little warm, but the warmer the better, because I have a little cutout over here in the exhaust just right under here. You won't be able to see it, just take my word for it. And it brings it around and it shoots the exhaust right on these tires. So that way I don't even have to do a burnout whenever I'm about to take off, and they're already warmed up. They're already sticky. And yes, I do have a catch under here, just because whenever I start flinging rocks everywhere, it all catches it. So I don't throw rocks through my fiberglass bedside. And over here on this side, if you follow me, she did get a little banged up. I'll tell you the story about that. All right. There was a Ford owner, all right? He was this big old lifted truck. He got stuck. I asked him if he needed some help. He said, yeah, he'd appreciate that. So I handed him a business card to the Chevy dealership down the street and drove off. Well, came back out the next morning, and I guess he didn't like what I had to say right there, so he left a nice little shiner on her. But you know, I still came out on top, because I drive a Chevy. All right, and I got these rain guards up here on the windows, because whenever somebody is talking about your truck, some reason they're always talking in the front of it. So now these things, they just deflect all the haters right off the side of it. So there is no hate that ever comes to my baby.
All right.
Well, my name is Shane. I'm pretty sure that's it.